be the City of Hickory cases presented by Matt Martin. The first one is HA 2022-01. That's Marvin Brooks Construction. Matt?
Thank you, Madam Chairman. Maybe for ease of discussion and public hearing, we take these first two items together as one. It is the same applicant, the same property, but two different requests. Number one is the special exception request. Number two is the accompanying variances request. Subject property is located at 506 and 510 West Lawson Street. These are two small vacant lots, currently zoned R10. As you see on the map on the screen, you see the zoning pattern that's dominated by R10. You also see that the, what I call the western terminus of Lawson Street, where it is into Newsom Street, which is a much smaller driveway, more like an alley than it is a public street. Character area is Neighborhood Activity Center, and that is because it's in the interior portions of Ahara. Aerial imagery, this is from 2007, but it depicts the vacant lots. These are under the same ownership as the house to the north, which is on a much larger lot. But you also see a lot of vacant property to the west and to the south. The only other house really in here is the property immediately to the east, which faces the other street. As we talked about in the work session, these are both non-conforming lots of record, which means they are existing legal lots, but they are less than the 10,000 square foot size that is required by R10. They probably predate Ahara's adoption zoning, and they've been vacant for a very, very long time. The applicant, through their construction company, is wanting to redivide the geography in here, take about 9 feet off of that larger lot to the north, leaving at least a 10-foot setback from the side yard, which leaves that conforming, add that small amount of land to this pair of lots, and then combine them all into one parcel. That's a little bit more than 12,000 square feet, which is more than enough for R10. But instead of two houses, it's residential duplex. Non-conforming lots of record are interesting creatures in that you're allowed to build a house on one if you can get it to fit. With these two small lots, they would be smaller homes, probably a little bit of a tough fit with the house front and rear yard setbacks, which we'll get into with the next item. But no really net change really. Since they are two small houses, they will be combined together in one as well. So as far as the special exception goes, staff is recommending approval of it subject to three conditions, which are there in your packet. Number one is combine all of the defective subject property into one parcel of land. Number two, all parking shall be off street on private property located to the sides of the duplex building. Driveways for each dwelling unit shall be paved to be of sufficient size to hold at least two automobiles entirely on private property, and no parking in the grass or front yard. And number three, special exception approval shall expire for 1 year from the date of approval if no replat has been recorded and building permits for the duplex issued by that day. I'm saying the applicant has wanted to get going on that. The variance consideration, we again covered it in the work session. I can go into more detail on that. But at the moment, do you have any questions about the special exception?
I just want to curious, Mac. It's showing 10-foot front yard setback, is that correct? So the intended parking is going to be on either side of the duplex, just for clarification.
Correct. They are requesting a reduced setback in the front only. That is covered with the next item. And with the duplex likely being a close, very wide side yard parking seems to make good sense.
So that's the reason, another thing to ask for two separate driveways just for that reason.
Correct.
Okay.
Well, you mentioned also backyard parking.
Backyard parking would be allowed to.
Okay.
I think that's something that's been explored.
Okay.
But if we get into the variances part of it, of course, in your packet, the two packets are almost identical. Boundary survey, you see the total area of tract one, which includes the 9 feet being borrowed from the property to the north, and makes it 0.28. The parent tract stays at 0.34 acres. The 0.28 is 12,000 and something square feet. Site plan, more detail here, but you see the this is after reconfiguration of lot lines. What they're proposing is a reduction of everything in the front yard. They higher and measures their setbacks in the front yard from the center of the street, which is a little bit unusual, but you translate that for discussion purposes. Their requirement is 35 feet from the front property line, 30 feet from the rear line. You're taking 65 feet off of an 84-foot parcel. That's going to leave a whole lot of room for building pad. The question becomes, I think they've got a pretty strong argument for relief. The question becomes whether front or rear yard or combination of both. Part of the thought process here that we've come over in the work session is if you look at the parent property to the north that faces Newsom as a single-family residence facing west, and for that we're part of a row of lots zoned R10. There would be a 10-foot side setback from each house. So if this lot that's the subject property did not have a street on the south side of it, and instead they had Newsom Street frontage, all that would be required there is a 10-foot side yard setback. So with that kind of comparison with the corner lot, staff thought that perhaps a better scenario would be to take some of the distance off of the rear yard and allow a little more room in the front. The front yard was not terribly concerning because of the lack of other buildings on the street. Vacant land to the west, vacant land to the south. The house to the east has about a 3-foot setback. So again, there's sort of an argument for a short distance. So staff's recommendation for the variances.
You can't hear.
Okay, I'm sorry, Mr. Gregory. Just retract a little bit more. I apologize. For whatever reason, we do not have an audio system here.
Just so. Talk loud then.
We'll just try to project a little louder.
Okay. So the recommendation for the setbacks is to the applicant's request to 10 feet on the front, maintain the 30 feet on the rear. So the recommendation is to increase the front yard from 10 to 15. And then allow the rear yard to be as low as 20 feet. So it gives a little more extra room, which is staff's view is flexibility for siding the duplex on the lot.
Okay. Okay. Makes good sense. All right. Do we have any questions other than what's already been addressed? All right. If not, we will, our public hearing will cover both items. We'll discuss the variances. I'm sorry. Yeah. Sorry. So for a matter of public hearing, we'll discuss both items, but thank you, but we will vote separately. So, all those are, and is there anyone here tonight who would like to speak in favor of this request, if you'll come forward, please? Anyone wanting to speak in favor? Is the applicant here?
Sure.
Okay.
Mr. Walter came to me and
if you will, for the record, please state your name.
My name is Marley Brooks, from Marley Brooks Construction. Mr. Lee Walter came to me to see what he could do with the property. He inherited this property. It's been in his family for a long, long time, for many generations, several generations. And he wanted to do something to be able to keep it in his family, but this is kind of an investment that he intends on passing down for his children and grandchildren. So it's not really, the property wasn't bought to be done this way. It was something that was inherited. And he feels like that, you know, the time has come, he's been blessed enough to be able to do something to give back to the community where he was actually reared. It used to be an old house there.
Does he intend for this to be rental property?
It will be. It is investment property, so it will be rental property. And I don't know that it was mentioned or not, that Mr. Martin had mentioned or not, but he owns the property, of course, behind it. That we're working, you know, that we're being the kind of part of it to get the minimum on the parking and footage. So that's really all.
You're just facilitating this and building a farm. You're not going to have any ownership.
No, I don't. I'm just talking.
All right, is there anyone else here tonight who would like to speak on behalf? All right, is there anyone here tonight wishing to speak against this request, if you'll come forward? Anyone wishing to speak against this request? All right, if not, I'll turn it back over to the commissioners. Is there any discussion, questions for staff? If not, then agenda item number 3, which is the special exception, I will entertain a motion for that.
Madam Chairman.
Yes, Commissioner.
Reference KHIRI 2022-01, the special exception, I recommend approval.
All right, we have a motion to approve. Do I have a second?
With the conditions, Madam Chairman.
Oh, I'm sorry. Are you indicating?
With the conditions.
All right, with the conditions set forth by staff, and that motion was seconded by Commissioner Wiles, okay? All right, any discussion on that motion? All those in favor of the motion to approve, please raise your right hand. All those against, and that carries. All right, moving over to the variance request. I will entertain a motion on that item.
Madam Chairman.
Yes.
Various requests by KHIRI 20-22-02, I recommend approval.
All right.
With the conditions.
As recommended by staff.
As recommended by staff.
Just to clarify, that's with the 15-foot in the front and 20 possible in the back.
And about the front facing garage, I forgot to mention that.
Okay, so I don't think it would much matter due to space, but Commissioner Bailey brings up a point. The language is a special exception for duplexes, plural.
Well, that would, if that is the case, that would be a typo.
Okay. So it is single?
Correct.
Okay.
Because the lot would be 12,000 square feet, not big enough, split into two.
Okay.
The non-conforming lot status of this existing small lots allows a house. It's not allowed to be placed.
Okay. If we'll make note of that for the record training. All right. So back to the motion to approve by Commissioner Graham, and that was with the exceptions laid out by staff.
Right.
All right. Do I have a second? All right. A second. All right, any discussion on that motion? All right, all those in favor of the motion to approve, please raise your right hand. All those against, and that motion carries. All right, and that is it for the KHIRI cases, and Matt, we'll come back to you, but we'll jump over to